212. Yeah. Special dedication to my brothers and sisters on the great continent of Africa. The saints in Malawi, Ghana, Nigeria, Kenya, Zimbabwe. Don't be deceived by what America's sending y'all, yeah, man. Let me begin. While there's still ink left in my pen, I'm set to contend. For truth, you can bet will offend. Deception within the church, man, who's letting them in? We talked about this years ago. Let's address it again. Yeah, and I ain't really trying to start beef, but some who claim to be part of the sheep got some sharp teeth. Whoa. And cats get mean when you criticize them. But Jesus told us, Matthew 7:16, we can recognize them. And God forbid that for the love of some fans, I keep quiet and watch them die with their blood on my hands. So there's nothing left for me to do except to speak to you in the spirit of Jude 3 and 2 Peter 2. And I know that some will label me a Pharisee, because today the only heresy is saying that this heresy. I dare to be specific and drop some clarity on the popularity of the gospel of prosperity. Turn off TBN, that channel is overrated. The pastors speak bogus statements, financially motivated. It's kinda like a pyramid scheme. Visualize heretics Christianizing the American dream. It's foul and deceitful, they're lying to people, teaching that camel squeeze through the eye of a needle. Ungodly and wicked, ask yourself, how can they not be convicted? Treating Jesus like a lottery ticket. And you're thinking they're not the dangerous type, cause some of the statements are right. That only prove that Satan comes as an angel of light. This teaching can't be believed without a cost. The lie is you can achieve a crown without a cross. And I hear it all the time when they speak on the block. Even unbelievers are shocked how they're feasting the flock. It should be obvious then, yeah, I'll explain why it's sin. Peep the Bible, it's in 1 Timothy 6:9-10. It talks about how the desire for riches has left many souls on fire in stitches, mired in ditches. Tell me, who would teach you to pursue as a goal the very thing that the Bible says will ruin your soul, huh? Yet they're encouraging the love of money. To make it worse, they've exported this garbage into other countries. My heart breaks even now as I'm rhyming. You wanna know what all false teachers have in common? What? It's called selfism, the fastest growing religion. They just dress it up and call it Christian. Don't be deceived by this funny biz. If you come to Jesus for money, then he's not your God. Money is. Jesus is not a means to an end. No. The gospel is he came to redeem us from sin. And that is the message forever I'll yell. If you're living your best life now, you're headed for hell. Talk to him. Joel Osteen.